Hydrogen bombs create a bigger blast, more shockwaves, heat, and radiation than atomic bombs. Though it has never been used in battle, a hydrogen bomb has the capability to wipe out entire cities and kill far more people than the atomic bomb. But could there be anything more powerful, more destructive than the hydrogen bomb? That's exactly the question we're going to answer right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to another LBQ. I'm your host, Charlotte Dobre. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe and let us know in the comments below what topics you would like to see next. To answer the question right off the bat, yes, there is something more powerful than a hydrogen bomb. An antimatter bomb. Antimatter weapons are much simpler than nuclear weapons, and they have the capacity to be the most destructive weapons in human history. So what is antimatter, and why is it so dangerous? Antimatter is matter with its electrical charge reversed, but when you mix matter and antimatter, they annihilate one another and convert their mass into a flash of energy. 1 pound of antimatter is equivalent to 19 megatons of TNT. For comparison, thermonuclear weapons have been estimated to be equivalent to 6 tons of TNT per metric ton. Antimatter bombs release more energy per unit mass. 1 gram of antimatter is comparable to a Hiroshima-sized nuclear explosion, and a 10 kilogram antimatter bomb would cause a 230 megaton explosion. There is no nuclear weapon that we know of that comes even close to this. To produce antimatter, you need a particle accelerator, like the one at CERN, the European Organization for Nuclear Research. Currently, the global production rate of antimatter is only 1 to 10 nanograms. There's also the possibility that we could harvest antimatter from a natural source. Both antimatter and matter were created after the Big Bang. The universe should be made of 50% matter and 50% antimatter. However, scientists have a lot of trouble finding antimatter, so instead they produce it in extremely minute amounts, amounts not great enough to cause a significant explosion as of right now. It costs trillions of dollars per gram to produce antimatter. To be exact, 1 gram of antimatter costs $62.5 trillion US to make, according to NASA, but it would cost only $600,000 to put a 10 millionth of a gram of antimatter into a sniper's bullet, which would be equivalent to 378 grams of TNT, more powerful than a modern grenade. But $600,000 for just one bullet is a lot. What if you miss? Even if we could produce more antimatter, or harvest it from some natural source, there's another problem. A serious problem. Antimatter is extremely unstable. It's one of the most unstable substances in the world. It annihilates upon touching ordinary matter, including oxygen, which makes it very difficult to contain. To enclose it, it needs to be kept in an airtight container, and held up with magnets so that it floats, keeping it from coming into contact with matter. But if the antimatter happens to shift the wrong way, is not held in place by the magnets, and comes into contact with its container, it will destroy the person holding it. That being said, it is possible to store antimatter. Antimatter was stored successfully for the first time in 2010 by scientists at CERN using a magnetic bottle called the minimum magnetic field trap. So what is the possibility that antimatter weapons could be put into practice? Well, the US Air Force has been apparently funding research into antimatter weapons since 1983, maybe earlier. NASA is also interested in using antimatter as rocket fuel because it's an extremely efficient energy source. Based on current estimates by scientists at Penn State University, antimatter could get us to Mars in just 6 weeks. At this time, scientists are not able to create enough antimatter to make a bomb, but as it stands right now, the antimatter bomb is the only weapon more powerful than a hydrogen bomb. Who knows, maybe in the future, antimatter will fuel our space travel, and we'll be able to go to other galaxies to harvest it. Maybe it will be the end of our planet. This has been Charlotte Dobre for Life's Biggest Questions. If you liked that video, you should also check out How Much Damage Can a Hydrogen Bomb Do? Or check out our playlist, Biggest What Ifs. Don't forget to click the bell so you never miss an upload. We'll be right back.